Ecuador. I got to see them plant these. And so one of the coolest things about going to the farm is seeing a new species of plant that isn't available on the market. And I forgot about it, totally forgot about it. Until they launched this, I thought, holy smokes, I saw that being planted. And here we are 3.5 years later, Ecuadorian oregano. Same, similar properties as Ecuador. It's in the mint family, Ecuador. I'm so sorry. Similar properties as oregano. There we are. It's in the mint family. So you can think about just that mint, oregano feel, but, or I should say, and, it's lighter than oregano. And from what I read from Gary's notes back in 2013, he spoke about this, that it shouldn't feel, there's a constituent in there that it makes it less warm on the skin. Oregano tends to be a little assaulting to my my nose, so I like to hold my hands out like this. Okay, that smells incredible. It really, it's like there's a hint of oregano, but it's different. So if you find, like I do, oregano to be a little bit off-putting, this is gorgeous. This I would diffuse. This is lovely, actually. I'm trying to think of what this smells like. It makes me think of horses. Is that weird? It doesn't matter if it's weird, it's what I think, right? So, and you have your own experience. All I can think of is horses. That's so good. I'm a huge fan. So I will be diffusing that later. I'm gonna find some other things to blend it with. I do like to blend, but that is really, and yeah, I have oregano on my hands, this Ecuadorian oregano, and it's not uncomfortable at all. So I'm waiting. Like when I put regular oregano on, it's quite hot on my skin, and I'm not tender. So I'm the one that puts pan away under the tongue. So there's